The styrene gas leak in Vizag has resulted in as many as 11 deaths and 5,000 people have been impacted by this chemical gas leak. To talk about the implication of this chemical disaster, we're being joined by G.D. Yadav. He is a renowned chemical engineer, Padma Shri awardee and former vice chancellor of the Institute of Chemical Technology in Mumbai. So thanks very much for taking time out. I want to first understand, what is your assessment of the situation? How harmful is the styrene gas and what sort of impact are we looking at of this chemical disaster in the long run?
Well, I must tell you that it is a very, very tragic incident, which should not have happened, but it has happened. And it has brought a bad name to the chemical industry. Because the accident of this kind, people will always try to relate that to Bhopal incident, because there was a gas leak there and 3,000 plus people died, and that is, you know, fresh in the memory of Indians. In this particular case, styrene is not a gas. Styrene is a liquid and it boils at 145 degrees centigrade. And what must have happened, based on whatever information they have provided on their website, and in fact, somebody from Andhra government called me when the incident took place to find out what to do. So apparently they had a storage of styrene liquid in a storage tank. About 1800 tons of styrene was lying there. Now styrene, has to be kept in storage with some inhibitors in it. That means it should not polymerize. And if it polymerizes, the polymerization reaction is highly exothermic. It liberates heat. And so what must have happened, it is my guess, that this polymerization might have started because styrene is susceptible to polymerization.
Okay.
And once the polymerization starts, the heat is liberated, and that heat is so excessive that the remaining liquid styrene is vaporized and goes into the atmosphere.
Okay.
Now, this is a huge volume of this styrene. Mm-hmm. And once it goes into the atmosphere, it depletes, it dilutes the oxygen concentration in that atmosphere. And people would find it difficult to breathe. And mm-hmm. some of them might have choked. And that could be the reason why it happened. Normally, in such cases, you know what normally they do, that always the tanks are located in such a place, there is an auto sprinkler system, as well as inhibitors are kept around, something which is called butylated catechol or butylated hydroquinone. And for that particular storage, almost 100 to 200 kg of this should have been there.
Mm.
And you put it and you can quench it. But at the same time, there should be water sprinkling. In many cases where styrene is stored, they also have refrigeration system.
Okay.
If one fails, another is used, so that there is no polymerization. The idea here is that it has to be stopped from polymerization. That is what has happened. So it is very tragic. They did not have any gas there, believe me.
Mm-hmm.
What they had is a styrene liquid. Otherwise, how styrene is made? Styrene is made from benzene alkylation, where ethylene is used. They make ethyl benzene, and ethyl benzene is dehydrogenated to make styrene. So none of that they had there.
Okay.
So the initial media report that it is a gas, it is not a gas, it is vapor. But of course, for a common man, gas and vapor doesn't make a difference. It is a gas for him, but actually it is styrene vapor.
Okay. So you talked about the Bhopal gas tragedy, and this, of course, is now being deemed as a tragedy, a chemical tragedy in India. 11 people are reportedly dead. 5,000 people have been impacted. What are the long-term impacts that we're looking at of styrene gas on people?
No, I tell you, styrene per se is a hydrocarbon. It is not soluble in water, okay? So styrene is not a gas, number one. But in any case, if there is any gas leak, what is the normal procedure to protect yourself? That also includes Bhopal.
Mm.
See, people are supposed to wet hanky or take a towel, wet with water, and hold it against your nose and mouth.
Mm.
And also drink copious quantity of water. In the case of styrene, they should have, and you run away from that.
Mm.
And what happens, the gas does not go into your body, in your mouth or through your nose, because the diffusivity of this gas through liquid, that liquid is water, is 10,000 times less.
Okay.
Supposing this accident had happened during daytime, perhaps these many deaths would not have been there. People would have run away. But this happened during wee hours of morning, and therefore people were asleep. That is another tragedy. And in this particular case, what must have happened? There must not have been any maintenance of that particular styrene storage tank or anything. So I think the lockdown people should have planned. And there is always a so-called SOP, standard operating procedure, for starting a plant, closing a plant, storage of liquids, storage of gases, and the chemicals, all those things. There is a standard procedure in industry. So perhaps, I do not know what operating procedures they had, but it is tragic and it will have a lot of impact on chemical industry. That is absolutely true.
Okay.
But I must also tell you that you cannot do without chemicals. So what we need is to have safer plants, safer operation of plants, and all industries do that. But some incidents, stray incident here and there, can tarnish the image of the industry. That is what actually happens.
I understand, sir. So are you telling me that after this, since you know it's highly vaporized, there will be no long-term impact on people who will want to come back in the vicinity of the polymer plant?
No, I will tell you something. See, if they have inhaled vapors, people have been taken to the hospital, they must have been treated and all. I cannot comment on that because it is a hydrocarbon. But obviously they are affected, okay? And the doctors will tell about it. But what I'm trying to tell you, that per se, polymerization of styrene is not a hazardous process.
Okay,
what has happened in this particular case is unfortunate. And that can happen. It is an accident. And any accident is, what is the definition of accident? It is unprepared, unexpected event. That is accident. So I'm sure they had some provision there to tackle the eventuality, but it has not happened.
Okay.
It has not happened.
Hmm.
That's okay. What I mean.
Okay. And since you were talking about ideal storage condition, I want to understand from you, what is the ideal storage condition of styrene? And also, where do you think the LG polymer plant failed, if at all?
Oh, very good question. Listen, whatever I know from the website they have given, apparently this plant has changed hands with two or three manufacturers, and the final was LG. Okay, and this styrene, you know, the styrofoam, which is used, for example, for packing and all. So that is polystyrene. So obviously this plant has been in operation for a number of years, maybe around 50 years or so. So nothing happened, but it does not mean the safety precaution should not be taken. No matter, you know, in industry, even if you have water, it has to be treated with respect.
Right.
Okay,
absolutely.
It has to be treated with respect. So obviously, they have failed somewhere. I cannot comment because judicial inquiry has been ordered. Okay, so it will be premature on my part to comment anything on that.
Okay. And sir, you know, perhaps my final question in that case, is there going to be any long-term impact of this gas leak, or is it something that the plant and the people can mitigate easily within a couple of days? You said mask is important, and a lot of people have asked this question, that if they were wearing masks, or let's say wearing a towel around their mouth, will it help?
With water, wet towel.
Yes, sir.
That would not have happened. Perhaps this impact would not have been. So perhaps there would not have been any death because people would be, awake, and they would run away from the incident. Here, people were asleep. So they did not know it. But I must also tell you, I cannot comment on that. It is the policy of the government. They will find out. But believe me, it is not just styrene. In the chemical industry, we must have proper safety precautions. And these days, what is told about is the safer plant operation. It is not only safer plant design, but safer plant operation. And that is true for all sorts of chemical plants, petrochemical plants, pharmaceutical plants. Believe me, you cannot do without these chemicals. Now, this corona has come, for instance. it is all chemicals, isn't it? Whether it's the hand sanitizer or the medicines or whatever polymers you use, it is all chemicals. So you cannot banish that industry. What you have to do is you have to take precautions so that you operate safely. And safer operation of plants is very, very important, and all industries must do that. It is not that you just set some plant and that is why these plants are outside. There are some industrial zones. That is the reason. So I personally believe the chemical industry must take a lesson out of it, and nobody should say that they are safe. Unfortunately, these long lockdowns, as and people have not gone and seen their plants, what has happened there. Perhaps they did not anticipate that. That's my guess. I don't know. I cannot comment on that.
But only a judicial inquiry perhaps can later clarify.
Yeah, because the judicial inquiry will come out. It will bring out the truth,
Right.
I feel very sorry for the loss of life, because it is innocent people and they have lost their lives. And so I think we should all feel sorry for what has happened.
Absolutely. Take a lesson from it and feel sorry for
it. I would say it is not deliberate. It is not deliberate. It is accident. It has happened.
Thanks very much, G.D. Yadav. Thank you for your time, sir. Thank you for enumerating on what is styrene and the impact of styrene on people in Vizag. Thanks very much.
Yeah. And actually, that particular event, because people did not know what to do. To stop that reaction, also you require, these inhibitors, which have to be dumped. So somebody has to be there near the plant. Mm-hmm. We do not know whether they were operators or they were engineers. Nobody knows how it happened. Mm-hmm. So the proper inquiry will reveal. Mm-hmm. Proper inquiry will reveal if there were any lacunae in the system. Whether they were operating it properly. Because even when you have a shutdown and you restart the plant, there are a lot of procedures are involved.
Right.
It's a lengthy procedure. It is not just ordinary thing. It is not just opening up a shop, mm-hmm. It's a chemical plant. So I think that there is some mistake, obviously. Mm-hmm. And I can't comment because it's a judicial inquiry.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you very much for your time, sir. Thank you, sir.